Hello everyone, my name is Monica Bhushan and today we are starting inverse Laplace transform lecture number 1. First we will understand what are the uses of inverse Laplace transform, why we want this inverse Laplace transform. So if you will go back to Laplace transform playlist, what we had seen there that maybe we have suppose some function which is in time domain. Okay, so some functions in time domain are not very easy to analyze or not easy to study. So we want to have some transform function so that this function will get transformed into some other domain that is called as frequency domain. Or sometimes we call it Laplace domain, S domain. My function is in Laplace domain. So the analysis we are done with. So this flow is actually from your Laplace transform. Now my function which is already in S domain. Now what we want? We want to transform this function back to time domain. So for that I need Laplace inverse. So Laplace inverse transform will give me the function in time domain. So this is, you can think, the reverse process. So frequency domain functions, we perform inverse Laplace transform and we get time domain functions. Okay, so now what actually is given in this formula list? So this function is your frequency domain function. We can write it as FS. And this is inverse Laplace transform. Inverse Laplace transform is what? This frequency domain function only we are writing down as what? FT. So once you are in inverse Laplace transform, now your function will be in T, in time. It won't be now further in S. Okay. So what we have done, we have just made the formula in three sets. Suppose this is your set number 1. This is your set number 2 and this is your set number 3. For today's class, we are going to see the questions, solve the questions which will be there from your these three sets. Okay, so what actually happens? This is 1 by S minus A form. This is your FS. Okay, so if you are performing Laplace inverse of this this function, you are going to get function in time domain and that is nothing but your e raised to AT. So if you remember that in Laplace transform, what we had seen, Laplace transform of e raised to at gives you the shifting, correct? The shifting in your s, it is your nothing but 1 by s minus a. Similarly, the second is your 1 by s, Laplace inverse of 1 by s gives you 1, okay? So you can derive from here also. Suppose this a is 0. So if I'm going to put here in this first formula, I'm going to put s minus 0, it will give me how much? E raised to a is 0, e raised to 0 t. And this is e raised to 0. Anything which has power 0 gives you 1. So this you have got. Okay, this is your set number 1. Set number 2 is what? This form is 1 by s square plus a square. Or the form is s by s square plus a square. So if the function fs is 1 by s square plus a square, then inverse Laplace transform of this function will be sine at by a. So remember that in Laplace transform also we used to do in the reverse manner. So this is sine at by a. Don't forget to write this by a is also there. Now, if it is s by s square plus a square, it is going to give you inverse Laplace transform of it is nothing but cos at. This is my formula set 2. Now my formula set 3 is what? The same thing. If it is your sine cos, it is your sine h cos h. H is for hyperbola. So this is your hyperbolic function. So sine h at, cos h at are nothing but they are hyperbolic function. So the formula for it is 1 by s square minus a square is inverse Laplace transform of this function is sine h at by a. And inverse Laplace transform of s by s square minus a square will give you cos h at. Now if you will compare these two formula, you will find that they are exactly same, only the difference is the numerator part is same, okay? The denominator part only, we have s square plus a square in sine at and s square minus a square in sine h at, similarly for your cos and cos h also. So what actually sine, cos, tan, these type of functions, how do we get? So suppose we used to get right angle triangle and the theta will be the ratio of these edges will give you sine, cos accordingly. And what is your hyperbolic functions? So we actually find hyperbolic function as the relationship between distance from the hyperbola, okay, distance from the hyperbola with that origin. So this might be one thing, this there could be many more things, right? So distance of this hyperbola with that origin, actually we study in the hyperbolic function. So in this course we actually don't need this analysis, so we are not going into these details. How to memorize this formula? So you know that h is for hyperbola, h is for hyphen, correct? No, this is totally illogical. Okay, so we are now starting the questions. So the very first question is 1 by s plus 2 plus 3 by 2s plus 5 minus 4 by 3s minus 2. So we are going to start, we are going to find inverse Laplace transform of this function. Why? Because we have the question given in s domain and my final answer will be containing t, correct? No, so because after inverse Laplace transform your answer will be in t. So how to start this type of question? So always remember two steps. The step number one is try to find out by looking at the question only, does it fall in these three sets? What are the sets? 1 by s minus a is one set. Second set is 1 or s, anything in the numerator, and the denominator will be s square plus a square. Either this is 1 or this is s. And the third set contains what? 1 or s in the numerator, and the denominator will contain s square minus a square. So always you keep in your mind, this will be your first step. So since you can see that the term number 1, 2, 3, 3 terms are there, all 3 actually can be done using this first set only, 1 by s minus a only. Okay, so second step is also there, which we will be discussing. So first step is done. What we are writing down, just three terms are there. So Laplace inverse of each term we have written down, L inverse, L inverse, N inverse. Okay, now what is happening? So this is actually straightforward. 1 by s minus a. A is what? Minus 2. So this is what? This is 1 by s minus a. Minus 2. So we have written down the final answer is e raised to minus, because a is minus. So minus 2. So e raised to minus 2t. So first term we got. What about my second term and third term? So here what we discussed, we need to see that suppose this is falling under this set 1 only. But set 1 says what? S minus a. S is not having any coefficient. The coefficient is 1, of course. So it is just s minus a. And we find that here 2s plus 5, here 3s minus 2. So my job is to take out this 2 from here. Just let it be s only everywhere, whenever you are finding it. So this is your second step. Always try to arrange this term so that s will be free with any coefficient. So, and again the numerator part also contains either 1 or s, correct? Either 1 or s. This is 3. So 3 is nothing but 3 into 1. So we can take out 3, it will be 1 by 2s plus 5. So this second term, suppose I am writing down Laplace inverse of 3 by 2s plus 5. And then this is what? Third term is Laplace inverse of 4 by 3s minus 2. So how I am going to write it? So this is 3 I'm just taking out. Okay, so 3 is there. Now I can write Laplace inverse of 1 by 2s plus 5. Then 5 I'm just taking, 4 I'm taking out. This is Laplace inverse of 1 by 3s minus 2. Okay, now after that what is happening here? So what we discussed, that we will try to make it as only s. So how I can do? Numerator I'm just keeping as it is. Denominator part, which is 2s plus 5, I am just going to divide by 2. If I am dividing it by 2, so I should multiply also with 2. So only with denominator I am doing these things. Okay, so why I am dividing it by 2? If I will divide it by 2, it will give me only s, and this 2 just I will take outside as the coefficient, as just the constant. Okay, so minus 4 Laplace inverse. What I should do here? This is numerator I am not touching. Denominator, since 3 is there, so 3s minus 2, I'm just dividing by 3. If I'm dividing by 3, I should multiply also with 3, then only it will get cancelled, no effect will be there. So what I can write? So 3 into, this is 1 by 2, I can take outside, correct? 3 into 1 by 2, because this is constant, then I'll write down Laplace inverse of 1 divided by 2s by 2 plus 5 by 2. Okay, now minus 4. Again, 1 by 3 is the just the constant. I can take out 1 by 3. This is Laplace inverse of 1 by this 3 I have taken out. So this is 3s by 3 minus 2 by 3. Actually, after practicing, you can write down without having these many steps. In one step also, you can write down. Okay, so this I am writing here. So what now next is 3 by 2. Laplace inverse of 1 by this 2 gets cancelled. This is s plus 5 by 2. Okay, now minus 4 by 3. Laplace inverse of 1 by 3 gets cancelled. This is s minus 2 by 3. Okay, so finally this is nothing but by 1 by s minus a term. So this is 3 by 2. Now Laplace inverse 1 by s minus a gives me e raised to a t. So a is what? S minus a. So minus will be, so minus 5 by 2 is your a, correct? No? So this is your this much into t. Now minus 4 by 3. This is again 1 by s minus a. So 1 by s minus a. So that means this is as it is minus. So a is positive in this case. So e raised to a is positive. Okay. So this is 2 by 3 into t. So this is only second and third terms answer. First we had got. Okay. So what we had done, we have actually followed two steps. Correct? No. First step is just check that which form you can put into. Second is always make this s term free with the coefficient. Okay, so second question we are starting. So second question is 2s minus 5 divided by 4s square plus 25. So among three sets, which set it is in? So second set, correct? No. Why? Because the first set is what? 1 by s minus a. There is no s. This is s square. Second is what? 1 or s, anything, right? No. So s square plus a square or 1 by s square minus a square. This is s square plus a square. But again, this s is having something with it. This is 4s square plus 25. Or you can do one thing, right? No. This is 4s square. You can write 2s whole square plus 5 square. This is also possible. So these directions you have to think actually. Fine. So what I am going to start with, I am just going to start how to find Laplace inverse. So what I should do actually, the numerator part either contains s or it contains 1. So what I'll do, I'll break the term into two terms. So what I will write down, this is nothing but 2s by 4s square plus 25 minus 5 by 4s square plus 25. And why I'm writing down, why I'm breaking it out? Because the denominator can be in s square plus a square form. But in the numerator only either s is there or 5 or 1 is there. 5 is nothing but 5 you can take out, 5 into 1, 1 will be there inside. 2 you can take out, s will be there only. Okay, so now Laplace inverse of 2s by 4s square plus 25 minus Laplace inverse of 5 by 4s square plus 25. So how we will be writing down now? So this is 2 I have just taken out. This is Laplace inverse of s by, now this is what? 4s square plus 25. So I don't want this 4 present here. If I don't want this 4 present here, what I'll do in the numerator, I'm not touching. 2 I've just taken out, s is there. So it is, I'm just dividing it by 4. If I'm dividing it by 4, in the denominator only, I'll just multiply also with 4. Minus Laplace inverse of 5 I have taken out, so this is 1. By, again 4s square plus 25 is nothing but divided by 4 into 4. Okay. Now what does it mean? So 2 Laplace inverse of s by, this is what? 1 by 4. You can write down this is nothing but 1 by 4. 1 by 4 I have taken out. So this is your 4 by 4. So this is s square plus 25 by 4. 25 by 4 you can write down 5 by 2 whole square. Why? Because I want to have s square plus a square form. 25 by 4 can be easily written as 5 by 2 whole square. Minus 5. This 1 by 4 again I am taking out. This is Laplace inverse of 1 by. So this 4 gets cancelled. S square plus again the same thing is there. 5 by 2 whole square. Okay. So now 2. So it is 1 by 2. Correct? Laplace inverse of s by s square plus a square gives you what? Cos. Correct? No. So this is your cos at. A is 5 by 2. So cos 5 by 2 into t. Okay, now my second term is what? This is your 5 by 4 and then 5 by 4. This is Laplace inverse of 1 by s square plus a square gives you what? This gives you sine at by a. Don't forget to write divided by a also. Sine at, a is 5 by 2. So 5 by 2 into t and then divided by a. A is 5 by 2 divided by 5 by 2 or you can write down into 2 by 5. Correct? So this third term is nothing but minus, this is 1 by 2 again. So this is 1 by 2 and then sine 5 by 2 t. And yeah, we also got the same thing. So this way we should solve this type of question. Okay, so we'll see this third question. So third question, again, first step follow whether this is 1 by s minus a or 1 by s square plus a square or 1 by s square minus a square, 1 or s, correct? So this falls under this third part. Why? Because s square minus a square is present. This is a square minus s square. You can write down minus of s square minus a square. Anything is okay, correct? No. So, but again, the second step is what? First step is done. You got that your answer should be having in hyperbolic function, cos hyperbolic or sine hyperbolic. The reason? Because it is the denominator is square minus a square form. But whenever you have s square minus a square form, you have noticed always think of, I'm not saying that it will be always there, but always you try to put into a square minus b square formula. That is, a square minus b square gives you what? A plus b into a minus b. So this is what? This is s plus a into s minus a. A square minus b square is a plus b into a minus b. So if I will break into this type, this form, so what actually will be there? So if I'm writing down first step is what? 2s minus 5 by 8s square minus 50 plus 4s divided by, I just write down minus here and then s square minus 9, s square minus a square form, minus is here. So again, this is 8s square, correct? No, so how I just make it into square? So what I can take out 2 common from this part. Maybe I'll just try. So this is 2 I have taken now. This is 4s square minus 25. And why I'm doing it? Because now it will be easier to write down 2s whole square minus 5 whole square. Then minus plus becomes minus 4s by s square minus 9. 9 is nothing but 3 square. So what is there? So 2, suppose 1 by 2 I have taken out. Now I'm just writing down Laplace inverse of numerator by denominator. Numerator is 2s minus 5, and if it is a square minus b square, so I just check whether I can do this form or not, a minus b into a plus b. So this, if I'll do, I'll see that these two terms easily get cancelled, and then this is 4 I just take out, Laplace inverse of s by s square minus 3 square. So now I got, I think, the answer also. 1 by 2, this is nothing but Laplace inverse of 1 by, okay, 2s plus 5. Again, 2s plus 5, so divided by 2 into 2, you will do similar fashion. Then 4, Laplace inverse of s by s square minus a square will give you cos h a t. So a is what? 3t. So minus 4 cos h a t. And this part is again what you will be doing, 1 by 2. You will again take outside 1 by 2. So it will give you s by 2 plus 5 by 2. So you will get this answer. Okay. So if you find this class useful, please like and subscribe my channel. Thank you.